just passing by to let you know my experience with the Mexico services.
Okay, and can you tell us a little bit about your experience, your expectations going into the trip?
My expectations, it's my second time coming back to Mexico. The only thing that was new this year that I did was I stayed with the hostel for 3 nights. My expectations were kind of different because, one, I was kind of scared because I didn't know what the family was going to be like. I didn't know what living conditions they were going to be in, how they pretty much worked. But my expectations were, my experience was totally different because the whole family that I stayed with, they have like a good living stable living condition. She had plumbing. She pretty much, it was like an actual constructed house, and she had everything, and like she had she has 2 kids. Well, she has twins. The twins had like their own bed. They had pretty much clothes. They even had like a big screen TV in their room, and they even had tablets. I didn't even have a tablet when I was that young.
Was that different than what other families experienced? Was that different than what other people from Hope Works experienced with their host families?
I think it was kind of different because certain youth, they had like plumbing and like they had electricity and things like that. But their house, I'm guessing like their houses were like kind of, they had a different living style from the family that I was seeing.
Okay. And tell us something that really touched your heart while you were staying with the host families.
One thing that kind of touched me like when I was staying there was they treated me like if I was family. Like, I got there Friday and like that I was pretty much family to them. And one thing that kind of surprised me was they're like, when they had like her brother used to visit her a lot, when he would talk to us, he would just talk to everybody. And it felt really good because it's like, I don't know them. And they were talking to me and they treated me like if I know them, it sounds like a little cool. And another thing was when our last day that we were there, the morning, before we came back, Danielle's host mom, she lives on like on top of the hill, so it was like a long way to walk back. We had told her like we would find our way back, but she was like, no, it's okay, we're already used to it, like we're already pretty much used to running up and down the hill if we wanted to. And she wanted to make sure that we were going to arrive safely back to our apartment. Like, she was with us the whole way. She made sure that we caught the taxi and we went home and that nothing bad was going to happen to us.
Okay. Anything else that you'd like to say to,
I'd say that pretty much, like, if you would be here with me to, like, experience this, I think you kind of agree with me when I say, like, appreciate everything that you have, because certain, like, over here, like, certain people don't have, like, things. Like, they might have, like a bed to sleep in, yeah. They might have, like, a little, like, a roof over their head, and they might have, like, electricity and things like that. But they can't have, like, that full experience of what it is to pretty much, like, go out one day, like, or just go to work and have enough money to pay for it and not have financial struggles. We'll have like enough money to pay for like all our utility bills and things like that. For them, it's really hard. So like, one, it could be like a certain situation where like, okay, so do I pay the light, do I pay the water, or do I get food? And it's like really sad to see them have to go through that struggle.
Okay. All right, thank you very much.